Let's take a look at the lifecycle of APT. It starts by identifying the attack target. For example, the target can be an automobile or aerospace company. Then, the attacker will research about the target, in particular, obtaining information about the target organization that can help the attack. For example, using network scanning and analysis, the attacker can learn the target organization's network and therefore the vulnerabilities of its network services, such as the possible security flaws of its web servers. And by researching the web, the attacker can also learn the organization's C-level executives and their email addresses. For example, many companies list their C-level executives on their web pages. And once you know their names, it is not hard to find their email addresses by doing some web search. Then, the attacker can develop a method to penetrate the organization's network. He can make sure that the attack will go through without detection by utilizing the knowledge he has learned about the organization. For example, the attacker can exploit a new vulnerability of the organization's web server. And since the vulnerability is unknown to the security community, the network defenses at the organization won't be able to detect this exploit. Or, the attacker can send a so-called spear phishing email to the chief marketing officer of the organization. It is called spear phishing because the attacker has spent time learning about the organization and the individual, and so the email would appear to be legitimate. Once the exploit succeeds, now the APT has a foothold in the organization. It can then communicate back to the attacker. For example, it can accept new malware updates, receives commands, etc. For example, it can now exfiltrate valuable data such as the design of a new airplane. The APT will try not to raise any suspicion so that it can go undetected. For example, it would only exfiltrate data from the server only when there are other legitimate network connections from that server to the internet. And it does not operate on any other server if that server is not useful to the current task. That is, it would keep its footprint as small as possible. Whereas the previous generations of malware, including bots and worms, would try to infect as many machines as possible. This cycle repeats and continues. For example, the attacker, based on information sent from the APT inside the organization, now learns that there is another part of the organization that also holds even more valuable data. The attacker now identifies that part of the organization as a new target. And this cycle continues.